The Breadwinner is an animated movie directed by Nora Twomey and written by Anita, Doron and Deborah, Ellis. And this is also based on Ellis's novel. It came out in the year 2000. It's a kids book, more or less. And the story is set in Afghanistan during the Taliban regime. And we follow this little girl whose father is thrown into prison and she has to provide for her family. So, since women pretty much can do jack shit in these situations, in that place, at that time, even today, unfortunately, she becomes a boy. She cuts her hair short and she starts helping out her family. And I was looking forward to this film, mainly because, well, all the nominations, whatever, it looked pretty interesting. That's what really sold me on it. It looked different, it looked like more of a mature film for families. And well, I can definitely say that it's better than a Ferdinand or a Boss Baby or even Loving Vincent. It unfortunately has the usual act-3 problem that many films, especially animated ones, have. And that's truly unfortunate because for the first two acts of this film, I was pretty much loving it. The story, it's painfully realistic, very brutal in a way that hits you very hard with the emotions, with the feelings, because we see the situations of many families in Afghanistan and how the Talibans are just beating them for doing something that's not really all that bad if you think about it. It's insane, things like women can't go out alone without her husbands or her brothers. They have to be with a man, with an older man possibly. And it's so many fucked up things that are real. And after that, we get this little girl and their little misadventures, and there are very touching moments, very nice ones. But the third act pretty much destroys everything that came before it, and that saddened me quite a lot, because we have multiple characters that are built up throughout the story, but there is something that happens, I won't spoil it, but in the third act that just made me go, why? And it also ends in a very bad way. It doesn't have an open ending, but it isn't neither a close ending, if it makes sense. It's as if there is one scene missing from the film, maybe they ran out of budget, I don't know, but I was like, no, this can't be it, this can't be it. We can still have one more scene directed, but no. It's not good. And that made me sad, but other things, well, the animation itself, it's gorgeous, I loved it. And there are two styles of animation. We have the 2D hand-drawn animation that you see in these stills, but we also have cut-out animation, similar more or less to the South Park cartoons. It's gorgeous, and these are stories told by the protagonist, Parvana, to her siblings. And that's what really, really worked for me, the whole theme of the importance of storytelling. The world in this film is grey, it's dirty, it's full of dust, it's lacking in color, but being able to just hide yourself and stop thinking about the real world by entering stories and dreams, they can be an escape from reality for the better, and that aspect I really, really loved. Unfortunately, they do something that I hate, and they do it constantly during these sequences, because we have the protagonist narrating the story to the siblings, and then she literally says what we are seeing and what the characters are saying. Things like, and then the boy gave the water to that person and thanked her, and then the boy says, thank you. And I'm like, well, okay, she's already said that, we know they was gonna say it, and they do it multiple times throughout this sequence, and it was getting annoying. Every time she said something like, and he said that he was very obliged to help. I'm very obliged to help. Like, what the f- come on, movie, you're better than that. And that's the other issue that I have. It has truly hard sequences for children. And I was almost considering this to be closer to an Anomalisa in terms of maturity. But then there are other moments that are almost childish. And it's very heavy-ended with the message. It's almost preachy in a way. so that it appeals to children, I guess, but it has a very confused identity. So I have to say, The Breadwinner is definitely way above the average of mediocre American-made animated films. It's nowhere near as good as Coco, unfortunately, sadly. But the animation is gorgeous, great voice acting, great setting, great story itself, but the execution, some of the problems with the narration, for example, those things just didn't work, and the ending truly, truly almost ruined the experience. But overall, the package is very darn good, so I definitely recommend you check out this film, mainly to support actually decently made animated films that have effort behind them. But still, guys, if you watched The Breadwinner, did you like or did you dislike it? Tell me in the comments below. Thanks for watching, to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Yeah.